Hi, I'm Maisie Golding.
And I'm Kathy Plumridge.
And today I'm going to be making a chocolate pudding.
Yum, sounds great. And I'm going to be making a chocolate banana.
Mm.
Welcome to Cookbook.
Pudding, you will need 60 grams of butter, half a cup of milk, 3/4 of a cup of caster sugar, 1 cup of self-raising flour, 2 tablespoons of cocoa, and 3/4 of a cup of brown sugar, and some water for later.
Okay, so I've preheated the oven to 180 degrees, and we start this recipe pretty much with something quite simple, a bowl. And some milk which has been microwaved and warmed up, so could you get that for me?
Of course.
Thanks. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the milk into the bowl. And then I'm going to get my butter and I'm going to put that into the milk.
And then I'm just going to mix it up.
And it usually takes about a minute or two for this to naturally melt.
Yeah, because it's melting quite quickly.
Yeah, because of the heat of the milk, so it works quite well. And then you can see now that's
mostly liquid.
Okay, and then the next thing I do is I add our caster sugar. Yeah, that's all good. And then we add our flour.
Good.
Just self-raising, so no need for bicarb or anything.
No.
Which I love. So we're good. So in goes the flour.
Whoops. I need this one.
That's going to look quite weird for a bit.
Yeah. It's a bit oatmeal.
It does, doesn't it? But it gets better. So
yeah.
After we've done this stage and it's all sort of mixed in into a kind of weird place, it will be a bit lumpy as well, that's fine. We then get our first cup of cocoa.
Yeah, and chocolatey bit.
Yeah. And then we add that in. Okay, so you need to beat it and you sort of need to get a bit harder with the beating.
Can you smell that?
Smells amazing.
Oh, it's the chocolatey bit. It's my favourite bit because now it's starting to look like a bit of a chocolatey
like
dish.
Like cake batter.
Yeah, exactly. So it's going good. We make sure all of that's mixed in.
It should look a very chocolatey.
It's quite thick now, isn't it?
Yeah. If you have a look at it, it should just be coming off the spoon like that. Now, Kathy, I've slightly misjudged the dish.
Oh dear.
Because we're going to cover it in water.
Oh.
Yes. I'll explain why in a minute, but we're going to cover it in water and I'm scared it's going to bubble over.
Well, lucky for you, I've brought my own dish! Will that work?
Perfect, yes, that will work. So, the next thing we do is we take this lovely dish and we add our batter, or whatever you want to call it, mixture. Into the dish.
In like this. Yeah, I'm glad we used a bigger dish. It wasn't going to hold. That just means more chocolatey yumminess for us, so I'm quite excited about it. Let me get all of that out.
So, now we've done that, I put that in there, and I'm going to get my brown sugar and my cocoa powder,
okay?
And I'm going to mix them together straight away. I do that because it's just easier to mix them up, more of a mixture. So, got my spoon. There's a lot of lumps. You kind of don't want this bit to be lumpy because this is the bit that's going to make the magic sauce at the bottom of the bowl.
Okay.
Yeah, so just taste. Yum. And then the next thing we do is we just sprinkle it very gently over the top of our cream.
I'm surprised it's sitting.
Yeah, it just sits on the top.
Just cover it really, you don't want to sort of suffocate it in chocolate.
So we've got a bit left over,
yep.
But that's where it should be.
Okay,
so pop that over there. Next thing we need to do is get some boiling water.
Okay.
And this is tricky because you've got to do it very gently, otherwise it will dent your mixture and you really don't want that.
That's 2 cups, I just feel like 1 cup.
Yeah, I think that's a good plan.
Makes the same measurement.
Almost, but yes.
And that looks fantastic. It does.
Well, it looks a bit weird now, but
I've not seen a cake like it before, well, where it's water as icing, but I trust you. I trust you.
But what happens is it sort of filters through the mixture.
Okay.
And makes its own kind of sauce.
We'll see. We'll see, won't we?
Yeah. So now I'm just going to pop it in the oven for...
Goes in there for 40 minutes. Right, so you've also got about 10 minutes. So I'm going to see if I can make my dessert in about 10 minutes.
Oh, bring it on.
So my dessert is for you people out there like me who hate cooking. I hate cooking, but I love eating. So it's beneficial for you who hate cooking but love eating, but also it's a bit healthy as well.
Yeah.
So what I've got down here is I've got a bit of foil.
It's yummy, it's foiled.
I've got a bit of foil, I've got a banana and a stick. But don't worry for you people who want a bit of chocolate. It's there, I've got the chocolate.
So how do we start?
Well, I've already started with step one,
peeling the banana, which is always a bit sticky.
Yeah.
But we'll get there in the end. Now, I have a weird thing where I don't like the whole banana.
I don't like it.
So I'm just going to snap that bit off.
Nice.
And put it there.
Cool.
Put it on your foil.
Okay, so now we've got the banana on the foil, we're going to get the stick, and this is the fun bit. We're going to skewer it essentially. Okay, so make sure not to come all the way out. And we're just going to lay it in the foil.
So you've skewered it.
I have. So next, very simple, we're just going to wrap it up. So this is to keep it nice and moist when it's in the oven. Because that's the next step, we're going to put it in the oven at about, let's say 150 degrees for about 5 minutes. It won't take long at all. So we're back from the oven. It was a long walk. It was a long walk for Kath.
Yes.
While yours is cooking, I'm just going to cover my cooking over a little bit. And the next step is the best bit, the chocolatey bit. And what we're going to do is we're going to put it in the microwave and warm it up for about, I'd say, 2 minutes, but with an interval in between just to give it a bit of a stir.
Cool.
Okay, so the chocolate has just come out of the microwave, so you can see it's got a nice consistency to it, it's nice and fluid, and that's going to be great for dripping onto the banana.
Yeah, it smells so good.
I know. So, next we're going to get the banana out of the oven. Okay, the banana is now out of the oven. I've put it on a plate because obviously it's going to be nice and hot. I'm just going to move this out of the way. And now comes the fun bit, mate.
Ooh.
So we're going to unroll it. If I can find the end, there we are. It should be nice and warm now. You can see it's got a bit of like where it's gone brown on the edges. So the fun bit, we're going to drizzle some chocolate on. So do you want to get a spoon?
Yeah.
We want to get, like, you can see there's a lot on there. It's up to you really if you want a lot or a little. But what I like about is not having too much on there is you can still see the stripes, so it's a quite nice pattern.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's about how much I would put on there. But it means we've got leftover chocolate, which we can have a nibble on later. So that is pretty much done.
So the pudding's nearly done.
Chocolate
now. No!
Oh, go on, dig in. Oh, this isn't your spoon, never mind. Oh, I don't care. Mmm.
Remember, it's really hot, so I'm not going to touch it, but...
Oh, we could share.
Let's share.
Yeah.
There's your spoon.
Oh, that's mine.
I'm
going
to go for a bit of...
Yeah.
Mmm.
Perfect, might be a bit hot. We just go through it.
Had your two desserts. I've been Kathy Plumridge
and I've been Maisie Golding and you've been watching Cookbook.